Today I'm going to go over my recent items that sold on eBay, which includes my biggest book sale ever. Hey everyone, it's Steve from Resale Dojo, where we grow our reselling businesses together. And today we're going to be going over my recent what sold items on eBay. And the main purpose of these what solds are for you to be able to get a nice list of items that you should be able to find at your thrift stores, garage sales, estate sales, retail arbitrage, online arbitrage, auctions, wherever, you should be able to find these items. All right, today I'm going to start with the category that I rarely sell on eBay or have not been listing on eBay for a while, and that is clothes and shoes. I just want to show you guys a few items you should be looking out for. The first item is this New Balance pair of shoes. These are actually men's size 14, which is a crazy big size, but the colorway on them were really cool. And I knew that they were gonna sell because I looked at the comps on them and they were selling really well, but I just needed to find someone with gigantic feet to buy them. So I eventually sold them for $79. I believe I had like $8 or $10 into these. So it was a really nice flip for me. Next two items are both Hawaiian shirts that I sold. One was a Caribbean, another one was a Jamaican Jack. So these are like no name brands that are out there, right? These are ones that you're gonna find for like a dollar, maybe $2 is the max of what I would actually pay for any of these shirts, but they both sold for me on back-to-back days. So if you have Hawaiian shirts that are not listed, especially silk ones or ones with funky patterns, make sure you get them listed right now because people are buying them. Next is a category they've been selling pretty well over the last couple of weeks, and it's sporting goods. So I wanted to highlight at least two items here that you should be looking out for. The first one is a Titleist AP3 iron that I sold. I actually bought this one for $2.49 and I sold it for $119.95. Titleist is definitely a bolo brand that you want to be looking out for. Anytime I find them, I check the comps on them. I found five of them at one store and I've already sold three of them. So they are some great money makers and they move pretty quickly. The next item that sold is this Louisville Slugger bat. Now this one, I took a best offer of $150 on it. It is the one that I won the challenge on. There were a few other competitors out there, so I wanted to just like get rid of it as soon as possible. I think I had $8 into it, and so selling for $150 is a great price. Now I probably could have got more money for this one. There were some comps that had sold for like $250, $300 out there, but mine is a little bit more beat up. There were a few more that had just popped onto the market. So I just really wanted to take the money because I did not want to wait out the season and just like lose out on potential sales in case, you know, I wasn't able to get it sold before the end of the summer and fall. And since we're talking about sporting goods, I sold this Riddell Pittsburgh Steelers helmet. This one I had, I think, $8 into it and I sold it for $120 free shipping. Now, this one is a replica. It does not have the real padding on the inside. It has like the fake padding on there. So it's not one that someone's gonna be able to wear, but it is a nice collector's item, something nice for the man cave. This is actually the third helmet that I found and sold. If you find any NFL or college helmets, make sure you check the comps on them. And if there are no comps on them, I would still pick them up if you get them for a really good price because you're gonna be able to set the market on them. The next item is this Braun coffee grinder. I believe I had $4 into this and I sold it for $40 free shipping. Now, an item that I picked up during the board game challenge is this London board game, and this one finally sold. I think I had like $3 into it and I sold it for $45. I've sold two modems recently. The first one's this Aeris surfboard that went for $99.95 and that one was used. The second one is this D-Link modem. This one was actually new and sealed that went for $71.95. I sold the Sony combo unit for $100. I believe at one point I had it at $119 and I saw that the sold comps had started to go down. So I lowered it and I sold it within a few days. One thing I want to recommend for anyone selling combo units out there is to just keep up with the market price, but don't lowball the market. There is plenty of margin out there on these items. You do not need to be the first one out when it comes to these. You could wait it out a little bit because they keep moving. Maybe be more around the 50th percentile when it comes to, or even a little bit higher, and just get that little bit more margin. Maybe you're gonna wait another week or two when it comes to it, but you're gonna be able to make, you know, like $20, $30, $40 more when it comes to these units. I also had some nice toner sales recently. The first one was this HP one that went for $39. And I also had this Canon one that went for $44. And both of these were new and sealed from the same store. I paid $3 for each of them and flipped them within 24 hours. All right, let's go over some video games that you should be looking out for. The first one is this Madden 08 for the PC. Now, this was in my PC video games list, so if you haven't watched that, make sure you go back and watch it. I go over a ton of PC games that you should be looking out for and flipping, and this one went for $32, and it sold for me within a couple of weeks of listing it. This Twisted Metal 2 for the PlayStation 1 went for $36 for me. I think I had like $2 into it. The next game that sold is this Spider-Man game for the Xbox 360. Always check the comps on Spider-Man games, regardless of system. They seem to always do pretty well for me. Some of the ones for like the PlayStation 2 or the original Xbox are not going for that good money, maybe like 12 or 13 bucks. But the ones for like the PlayStation 3, Xbox 360, those ones usually go for at least $20. And just like Spider-Man, you want to look at all the Toy Story games as well. This Toy Story 3 game for the PlayStation 3 went for $22 as well. That is always a brand of game that I'm checking the comps on when I find them. And sticking on the subject of brands of games that you should be looking out for, any of the Tony Hawk games you want to check the comps on, this American Wasteland one for the Xbox 360 went for $31. Always check the comps on Tony Hawk ones because some of them go for some really good money like this one. They do fluctuate at times, so you just want to check out what the prices are when you find them. An item that was sitting in my death pile for a bit is this Guitar Hero Explorer guitar. I lotted it up with Guitar Hero 3 for the Xbox 360, and I sold it for $110 shipped. And the last game for today is this Gauntlet game. It's Dark Legacy for the original Xbox. It went for $40 disc only, so you definitely want to remember this one when you're searching. All right, let's go over some recent DVD sales. The first one is this Babylon 5 set. It is season 4. This one was complete and sealed, and it went for $31. Now, I wanted to highlight this because a lot of times Babylon 5 does not do well for me, but if you do find the sealed ones, you can get some value out of them. The next sale is this lot of Diagnosis Murder DVD sets, season 6 through 8. And these, if I sold them individually, they probably would have gone for like 15 to 18 each. And I really did not want to wait out for each of these seasons. And since I had the straight run of 6, 7, 8, I put them together and I got $44 for them. So that's my strategy when it comes to series. If I can find a few of them to lot up, I definitely will, because I don't want to have to worry about three sales if I could get one sale out of it, even if I'm making a little bit less than I would have if I sold them individually. Another series I lotted together are these Knots Landing season 1 and 2 sets. One of them was sealed. It looks like season 2 was sealed and season 1 was used but in really good condition, and I got $55 for this set. The next one is this Atmosphere FX DVD. This one was new and sealed and went for $28. But this is one you want to look out for, especially coming up to Halloween time. People are going to be wanting to decorate their houses. This is one that you put in and they project onto like walls or windows and stuff like that. So if you find these, get them listed right away. You might be able to make some good money on them. As I've said before, always look for anime. This Card Captor DVD went for $63. I had like $1 into it. This one sat for a while, but it was more of a lotto ticket item that I had. Someone else, I think, had it listed for, I don't know, like 80 or 90 bucks. I underpriced them and just waited it out, and I think it sold within like 4 months. This 9-inch nail set sold for $45. I had it listed for 12 hours before it sold. Now, I think mine was a little bit more rare compared to the other ones out there because mine was DVD and Blu-ray, and I think other ones that were out there were just DVD. So, you know, I underpriced it, I don't know, but I sold it within 12 hours, and I only had like $3 into it. I sold this lot of Sporty's Pilot Shop DVDs. Now, this is some type of series that shows you how to like fly helicopters and airplanes. I paid $1 for each of these, lotted them up, and sold it for $55 free shipping. And I definitely saved the best for last here, the Story of Civilization book set by Will and Ariel Durant. It's an 11-volume set, and it sold for $270 free shipping. I think I had $28 into it altogether after my discounts. Now, it did cost a little bit to ship, but it is going medium mail. I think it was like $30 to ship it altogether. So those were my best recent sales. Let me know down below what was your best sale over the last couple of weeks. And make sure you leave a thumbs up on your way out. If you enjoyed this video, YouTube's gonna recommend a few of them over here for you. Check one out if you have a little more time. And as always, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.